गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज़ अरविंद, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ ट्रिपल ई, DBSIT, कावली. सो इन द प्रीवियस क्लासेस आई डिस्कस्ड अबाउट वेरियस मेथड्स टू डिटरमाइन द वोल्टेज रेगुलेशन ऑफ एन ऑल्टरनेटर और सिंक्रोनस जनरेटर. सो दोज आर EMF मेथड, MMF मेथड एंड ZPF मेथड. एंड नाउ इन दिस क्लास आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस ASCA method, that is American Standard method. So this is the last method to determine the voltage regulation of an alternator. So after that I will discuss SCR, short circuit ratio, and Blundell's two reaction theory also. Okay, firstly I will start with ASCA method. So that is American Standard Association method. So actually in the previous classes I discussed about two methods, that is the MMF and EMF methods. So based on those two methods, they are giving the reliable values of the voltage regulation. That MMF and EMF methods are giving the reliable values of the voltage regulation. But here we are facing some errors in the results of these methods are mainly due to the two reasons. One is in these methods, the magnetic circuit is assumed to be unsaturated. Okay, in these methods, the magnetic circuit is assumed to be unsaturated. But this assumption is unrealistic as in practice. Okay, next, it is not possible to have completely unsaturated magnetic circuit. Okay, it is not possible to have completely unsaturated magnetic circuit. Okay, next, second reason is, so in salient pole alternators, it is not correct to combine the field ampere turns and armature ampere turns because the field winding is placed on a pole core and armature winding is always distributed. So that's why there is no reason to combine the field ampere turns and armature ampere turns to the salient pole alternators. So these are the two causes, two errors results in the effect on the voltage regulation of an alternator. But here we have two MMFs acts on magnetic circuits. Actually, the magnetic circuit consists of two MMFs. Axon magnetic circuits having different reluctances. Okay, different reluctances in case of salient pole machines. So hence phasor combination is not fully justified. So here the phasor combination is not fully justified. That means in the MMF and EMF methods, not in ASCA method. Okay. So and coming to the ASCA method, that is American Standard Association method. So due to simple construction, the ASA method is very commonly used for calculation of voltage regulation. So here we have to assume two conditions. One is saturation effect is considered. So here in this case, the saturation effect is considered. And second one is leakage reactance, that is XL, and armature reaction reactance, that is XA, are considered separately. So this method is based on the modification of ZPF method. So in the previous class I discussed about ZPF method. So this is also called as Porsche triangle method. Okay, so this ZPF method including drop due to saturation effect. Okay, so hence it gives highest accurate result. So actually this ASA method requires mainly two characteristics similar to the ZPF method. It also consists of the OCC characteristics, that is from the OC test, and ZPF characteristics, that is from the zero power factor test. Okay, so from the above test data, that means from the OCC characteristics and ZPF characteristics, we can draw the graph as shown below, that is similar to the ZPF method. That is, in the ZPF method, we drawn Porsche triangle. Okay, so actually the characteristic diagram consists of the OCC curve and ZPF curves. So in between we have the Porsche triangle. So in that class also I discussed the procedure to draw the Porsche triangle. So same procedure will be applicable to this one. Okay, so let's see. So this one, so this is the ASCA method graphical representation, and this is the phasor diagram of the ASCA method. Okay, so from the above test data, that is from the OCC test and ZPF test, we can draw the characteristic diagram for the ASCA method and phasor diagram also. So this is the ASCA method diagram. So in the x-axis, we take in the field current as the base. And on the y-axis, I am taken full load terminal voltage and open circuit voltage. Okay, so here I drawn two curves. So one is OCC curve and another one is ZPF curve. So in between OCC and ZPF, we have the triangle. So this triangle is known as Pochier triangle. And here I drawn a air gap line. So this is also known as tangent line. So this tangent line is drawn parallel to the OCC curve. It touches the OCC curve. Okay. And next, coming to the phasor diagram. So this phasor diagram here, I am taking the V phase as the reference. So this wave phase lags the armature current at a phase difference of phi, and it consists of the drops, that is IRA drop and IAXL drop, and it consists of the E phase, that is the terminal voltage, full load terminal voltage, okay, and some currents is also present here, IF1 and IF2 is the field currents, and IFR is the resultant field current of this one, okay. So like this, we drawn these two diagrams. I will explain how this in the ZPF method. Also explained how to draw the characteristic diagram for the ZPF method, and now I am going to discuss how to draw the characteristic diagram for the ASA method. Okay. So coming to the procedure for calculating the voltage regulation. So from the data of OCC and ZPF test, draw the OCC and ZPF characteristic curve. So that is in the figure one. In the previous slide. So in the diagram, we drawn the OCC curve and ZPF curve in the graph. And after that, after completing the ZPF and OCC curve, I drawn a tangent line that is called air gap line to the OCC. I drawn a tangent line that is the that touches to the OCC curve and goes away. So that line is called as air gap line or tangent line. And from point A, the point A is obtained from SC test with full load armature current. Okay, here we have point A that is obtained from the SC test. This one A, so this one is obtained from the SC test with full load armature current. Hence, OA represent field current. So this one, this is the origin point O and A. So this OA line represents the field current, which is equal and opposite to the demagnetizing effect. Okay, that OA represents field current, which is equal and opposite to demagnetizing effect, and balancing the leakage reactance drop at full load, And next, fourth point is fixed point B on ZPF curve. So if you observe this one, the point B is fixed in the ZPF curve. This is the ZPF curve. Okay, this green line is the ZPF curve. Here we mentioned a B point. So here the B point is fixed on ZPF curve corresponding to terminal voltage per phase. So if you see, so this one V phase, terminal voltage per phase. So here I indicating the V phase on the Y axis. So here I drawn a horizontal line. It touches to the Pochier triangle and it touches to the B. So this one. Okay. Next. So from point B, draw a line with length BH, okay, which is equal to OA. So from point B, we draw a line BH, it is equal to the OA length. So this OA length, same length considered for the BH line, I draw a BH line, okay, it touches to the OCC curve, okay, So from point H, draw a line which is parallel to air gap line. Okay, from point H, we drawn a line which is parallel to the air gap line. Okay, Okay, next. Hence, we get a point D on OCC. So, after that, we get a point on D, this one. Okay, we have point on OCC curve, that is D. I mentioned with the D point. Okay, point D on OCC. Now, connect points D and B. Okay, now connects points D and B. Okay, D and B. So what we get? The Pochier triangle. Okay, forms D and B, forms a triangle called Pochier triangle. And next, draw line DE parallel to voltage axis. Okay, here I am drawing a DE line. So this one parallel to the OCC. Parallel to the voltage axis. Now DE represents leakage reactance voltage drop. DE point represents that line. Horizontal vertical line represents the leakage reactance voltage drop. Okay, that is IAXAL. Okay, next from EMF using E is equal to, we have the formula that is root of V phase cos phi plus IARA whole square plus V phase sin phi plus or minus IAXAL whole square. So this is the EMF equation for the ASA method. But from the graph that is from the OCC, measure the field current that is IF1 corresponding to the rated voltage per phase that is V phase from air gap line, and IF2 is the field current required to produce the full load current on short circuit. That is nothing but the ZPF. Okay. So now the resultant field current that is IFR. Okay. Now the resultant field current IFR that is root of IF1 square plus IF2 square plus 2 into IF1 into IF2 cos of 90 plus or minus 5. I told this equation from the vector diagram, that is a second diagram, that is also known as phasor diagram of the ASA method. So from the diagram, I taken this resultant field current value, and next from the graph, project a line from E point on Y axis towards the OCC. Okay, from the graph, that is from the graph. Okay, that is the first diagram. From the first diagram, project a line from E point on Y axis, okay, towards OCC, and then it cuts at point L on air gap line and point J on OCC. Now the length of line IJ is equal to field current IF3. Okay, this one, field current IF3. So this one IJ line is there. So it touches the OCC line. Okay, so it forms the IF3 line. Okay. So actually from the OCC and ZPF we have the field current IF, and next from this V phase and A line between this one, so we have IF1, and same point IJ we have the IF3. So if you observe the phasor diagram you will understand. So this line is the IF1 line and this line is the IF2 line. Okay, it is in the same phase to the armature current. Okay, and the resultant field current is there, IFR. Okay, next. So find the total resultant field current as IF is equal to the combination of IF1 and IF3. Okay, next, from OCC curve, find the EMF per phase corresponding to resultant field current IF. Okay, so now the percentage of voltage regulation is equal to E phase minus V phase by V phase into 100. Okay, so this is the voltage regulation. Calculation of voltage regulation for ASA method. Okay. And next, coming to the comparison between the various methods, what we discussed in the previous classes and in this class, I taken these methods to compare. Okay. So I will take the four methods, that is a direct loading method, EMF method, MMF method, and Porsche triangle method. That is nothing but ZPF method. Okay. So here I will give the comparisons between these four methods. So actually, coming to the first direct loading method, so actually in this method the alternator is directly loaded, that's why it is called direct loading method. Okay, and next, coming to the EMF method, so in this method the alternator is not directly loaded. Okay, these are the indirect methods, EMF, MMF, and Porsche triangle and ASA method. These are all the indirect methods. Okay, and next, coming to the MMF method, so in this method the alternator is not directly loaded, same point, only the difference is in the direct loading method the alternator is directly loaded, but here the alternator is not directly loaded. Okay, in the Porsche triangle method also same point repeats, that is in this method the alternator is not directly loaded. And coming to the second comparison, so here in the direct loading method the load up to full load capacity of alternator is to be arranged in the direct loading method, and coming to the EMF method, no necessity of arranging the load up to the full load capacity of the alternator, there is no need. Okay, and in the MMF method also no necessity of arranging the full load up to the load up to the full load capacity of alternator, and in the Porsche triangle also same point repeats, so no necessity of arranging the load up to the full load capacity of alternator. And coming to the third comparison, so in the direct loading method it is direct method for finding the voltage regulation, And coming to the EMF method, it is the indirect method for finding the voltage regulation. And coming to the MMF method, it is also indirect method for finding the low voltage regulation. And coming to the Poisson triangle method, it is also an indirect method for finding the voltage regulation of an alternator. And coming to the fourth comparison, there is a wastage of energy. The alternator is loaded up to its full load capacity. Okay. Here in the EMF and MMF and Poisson triangle method, the energy is not wasted because we are not connecting the load directly, and that to full load we are not connecting. That's why there is no wastage of energy in the three methods, EMF and MMF and Poisson triangle. Okay, and next, coming to the fifth comparison, so this method give accurate results as alternator is loaded, as alternator is directly loaded and readings are obtained. Okay, and in the EMF method and MMF method, Poisson triangle method, so these are gives large values of synchronous reactance. Okay, so EMF method gives the larger values of synchronous reactance, which leads to higher values of regulation than actual values. Okay, hence it is called pessimistic method. Actually, in the concepts of EMF and MMF method, I'm explained the limitations. So in those limitations, we have these optimistic method and pessimistic methods like that. Okay, so in the EMF method, actually it gives the larger values of synchronous reactance values. So that's why we get the higher values of regulation than the actual values. Hence that method is called pessimistic method. And in the MMF method, so this method gives regulation which is lower, okay, lower than the actual values. Hence it is called optimistic method. Okay, and coming to the Poisson triangle method, so it takes into consideration the armature resistance, okay, armature resistance and leakage reactance drops and effect of armature reaction. Hence results obtained are nearer to the reality, that is nearer to the actual values. Okay, so and coming to the sixth comparison between these four methods, for the direct loading method, no other tests are required other than the direct loading in the direct loading method. And coming to the EMF method, so the tests are required to be conducted are open circuit test and short circuit test in the EMF method. And coming to the MMF method, tests required to be conducted are open circuit and short circuit test. And coming to the ZPF method, the tests required to be conducted are open circuit test and zero power factor test or ZPF test. So these are all required tests to perform the tests on voltage regulation, to find the voltage regulation of an alternator in these methods. And coming to the seventh comparison, so in the direct loading method, it is not used for large ratings of alternators. So the direct loading method is not used for large ratings of alternators. And coming to the EMF method, it is used for large ratings of alternators. And this MMF method also used for the large rating of alternators. And the ZPF method is also used for large rating of alternators. And coming to the last comparison, that is eighth one. So in the direct loading method, there is no necessity to plot any curve, and regulation can be determined at any power factor condition. Okay. And coming to the EMF method, regulation of alternator at any load condition and power factor condition can be determined. Okay. And in the MMF method, the regulation at a desired power factor condition can be obtained. Okay, and coming to the ZPF method, the separate curves for every load condition are to be plotted if regulation at various load condition is required. So these are all the comparisons of the various methods we have to determine the voltage regulation of an alternator. So next I'm going to discuss short circuit ratio of an alternator. Okay, so firstly we will see what is meant by short circuit ratio. So that is the short circuit ratio, in shortly we will call it as SCR. So this SCR is defined as the ratio of field current required to produce rated voltage on open circuit to the field current required to produce rated armature current with the armature terminals shorted while the machine is mechanically run at synchronous speed. So this is the definition for short circuit ratio. So the short circuit ratio is defined as the ratio of the field current, that is IF, required to produce rated voltage on open circuit to the field current required to produce rated armature current with the armature terminals shorted while the machine is mechanically run at synchronous speed. So this is the diagrammatic, sorry, graphical representation of short circuit ratio. So here we have, I am taking two sides. So on the left side we have open circuit voltage and on the right side we have short circuit current. So in between we have two curves. So one is for the open circuit characteristics and one is for the short circuit characteristics. Okay. So based on these two curves, we have slope K1 and slope K2. So the slope K2 is from SCC curve and slope K1 is from the OCC curve. That too from the tangent line drawn between the touches to the O point to the OCC curve. Okay. And next, this SCC. So actually from the OCC, we have the rated voltage and from the SCC, we have the rated current, that too armature current. Okay. And thus the point touches from the OCC to the SCC is indicated with F dash and from the SCC it is indicated with the F double dash. So based on this graph, I am taking the formula, that is from the OCC and SCC as shown in the figure, from that is SCR is equal to OF dash by OF double dash. So that is OF dash. So this OF dash gives the OCC and OF dash dash gives the SCC curve. Okay. That is, the OF dash is nothing but the rated voltage on the open circuit and OF F double dash gives the rated armature current with the armature terminals shorted. Okay. That is OF dash by O double dash and SCR is equal to 1 by XS. That means SCR is the reciprocal of per unit synchronous reactance. Okay. Here a small value of SCR indicates large value of synchronous reactance. Okay. A small value of SCR indicates the large value of synchronous reactance. Here SCR of high speed turbo alternator usually lies between 0.5 to 0.75 and a low speed salient pole alternator lies between 1 to 1.5. Okay. Next, with the higher value of SCR, stability limit is increases and voltage regulation is also improved. So this is the concept of short circuit ratio. Okay. Next, coming to the Blundell's two reaction theory. So actually we knew that in non-salient pole type alternators the air gap is uniform. So we knew that in non-salient pole type alternators the air gap is uniform. So due to the uniform air gap, the field flux as well as armature flux vary sinusoidally in the air gap. Okay, sinusoidally vary in the air gap. But in non-silent pole alternators, air gap length is constant and reactance is also constant. Okay. So this two reaction theory was given by Professor Andrew Blundell. So it is named as Blundell two reaction theory. Okay. So due to this, the MMFs of armature and field act upon the same magnetic circuit all the time, hence can be added vectorically. So here we have MMFs of armature and field, these two are act upon the same magnetic circuit, okay, all the time, hence can be added vectorically. But in salient pole type alternators, the length of air gap varies and the reluctance also varies. So here, hence the armature flux and field flux cannot vary sinusoidally in the air gap in the Blundell's two reaction theory, that is in the salient pole alternators. So here the reluctances of the magnetic circuits on which MMFs acts are different in the case of silent pole alternators. Okay. Hence the armature and field MMFs are given special importance while given less importance in the non-silent pole alternators. So in the non-silent pole alternators, there is no importance to the armature and field MMFs. Why? Because these are constant. But here in this case, we are giving importance to the armature and field MMFs. Okay. So there are some disturbing factors in silent pole alternators which are analyzed here. Okay. So the theory which gives the method of analysis of the disturbing effects caused by the silent pole construction is called two reaction theory. Okay. So the theory which gives the method of analysis of the disturbing effects caused by the silent pole construction is called two reaction theory. Next, according to this theory, the armature MMF can be divided into two components. One is component acting along the pole axis called direct axis, and component acting right angles to the pole axis called quadrature axis. These are the two components we have for the armature MMF in the Blundell's reaction theory. So the component which is acting along the direct axis can be magnetizing or demagnetizing. Okay, the component which is acting along the quadrature axis is cross magnetizing. Okay, these components produce the effects of different kinds. So here I will show the diagram. It shows that the stator MMF wave and the flux distribution in the air gap along the direct axis and quadrature axis of the pole. Okay, so this is the diagram. Okay, so on the left side we have direct pole axis, on the right side we have quadrature axis of pole. So here we have pole and flux and armature winding and direct pole axis and stator MMF wave. So actually in this one we have stator MMF wave from these two diagram. So here the flux is flowing in a simple manner, but here on the quadrature axis of pole the flux is distributed like this. Okay, so it is distributed, but here on the right left side we have the flux is flowing in the normal way, but here on the quadrature axis pole the flux is dividing. Okay, on the right side and left side it is dividing. Okay, so these two diagrams consist of armature winding and flux and pole and direct axis pole and quadrature axis pole and stator MMF waves. Okay, so here we have positive and negative sides, and here also we have positive and negative sides. The positive and negative poles, we have the direct axis pole and quadrature axis poles in the both the diagrams. Okay, so this is the diagrammatic representation of the Blundell's two reaction theory, and in this one the reluctance offered to the MMF wave is lowest when it is aligned with the field pole axis. Okay, this axis is called the direct axis of pole, that is on the left side of the diagram. Okay, the reluctance offered to the MMF wave is lowest when it is aligned with the field pole axis. This axis is called the direct axis of pole, that is D axis, and the reluctance offered is highest when the MMF wave is oriented at 90 degrees to the field pole axis, which is called quadrature axis, that is Q axis. Here the air gap is least in the center of the pole and progressively increases on moving away from the center. Okay, so due to such shape of the pole shoes, the field winding wound on salient poles produces the MMF wave, which is nearly sinusoidal, and it always acts along the pole axis, which is direct axis. Okay, next, so let F suffix F be the MMF wave produced by the field winding, then it always acts along the direct axis, and this MMF is responsible for producing an excitation EMF, that is EF, which lags FF by an angle 90 degrees. Okay, so when the armature carries current, it produces its own MMF wave, that is FAR. Next, this can be resolved into two components, one acting along D axis, that is magnetizing or demagnetizing, and one acting along Q axis, that is cross magnetizing. Okay, similarly armature current IA also can divide it into two components, one along with the direct axis and one along with the quadrature axis. These components are denoted as FAR. So here we have FD, that is the component along the direct axis, and FQ, that is the component along quadrature axis, and IA, that is component along direct axis, and IQ, that is the component along quadrature axis. So the positions of FAR, FD and FQ in space are shown in the next diagram. So the instant chosen to show these positions in such that the current in phase R is maximum positive and is lagging EF by angle psi. Okay, so here this is the diagram. So it represents, it gives the FD, FAR and FF and R like that we have. Okay, here we have two circles and we have two poles, that is north pole and south pole. So based on this, we have axis of coil, that is R, R dash. We have negative and positive side. So in between the poles, we have direct axis and quadrature axis. So the direct axis consists of FF and the quadrature axis consists of FQ, and the resultant FAR is also there in between these two, and FD also we have. Okay. So the phase diagram of MMF wave positions in silent pole machine is shown here. So this is not a phase diagram. Okay. So the diagram consists of FAR and FD and FQ. Okay. Next, so it can be observed from the figure that FD is produced by ID, so which is at 90 degrees to EF, while FQ is produced by IQ, which is in phase with EF. So this is the diagrammatic representation of that explanation. So on the y-axis we have direct axis, and in the y-axis we have quadrature axis. Okay. So based on this diagram, so it can be observed from the diagram that FD is produced by ID. So here FD is produced by ID. So FD and ID is in the same phase. If you observe this diagram, FD and ID in the same diagram, this is represented in the D axis. Okay. Next, which is at 90 degrees, exactly 90 degrees to EF, which is 90 degrees to EF. And next, we have, while FQ is produced by IQ. So here FQ is produced by IQ. So on the x-axis we have FQ and IQ is in the same phase. Okay. So that means which is in phase with EF. These are all in phase with EF. So this one. So FQ, IQ and EF are in the same phase. Next, the flux components of phi AR. Here we have the flux, that is phi AR. Here it consists of the components, that is phi D and phi Q respectively, are also shown in the diagram. Phi D and phi Q is also in the this diagram. So this one, phi D, phi Q. Okay. Next, so it can be noted that the reactance offered to flux along the direct axis is less than the reactance offered to flux along the quadrature axis. So due to this, the flux phi AR is no longer along FAR IA or IA. Depending upon the reluctances offered along the direct and quadrature axis, the flux phi AR lags behind armature current IA. Okay, so that's it. Thank you. Okay, in the next class, I'm going to discuss the determination of XD and XQ, that is direct axis reactance and quadrature axis reactance, and some numerical problems on these tests are also I'm going to discuss in the next class. Thank you.